What's up, guys?
I'm Jordan.
I'm Brandon.
I'm Tiffany.
And this is
Bird Squad.
Today we're gonna be reacting to Nicki's album Queen, and as you can see, I'm the most excited about this album.
She is by far the most excited about this.
I love Nicki. Okay.
Would you say you are a Barbie or Barb?
A Barb? Yeah, I'm totally stand for Nicki. Definitely.
She cool to me. I mean, I have nothing negative to say about her. Like she awesome flow. I love her punchlines. She cool, like she cool.
I'm
looking forward to seeing like how the music is. But she got them bops, like that. Step up in the party, like my name is Miss.
I don't want to hear anything like that. I was thinking more like.
I was thinking like moment. I thought that's what you were gonna say. Not check it out.
Nah, something more like her monster freestyle.
Like that waves on.
No, yeah, no, I definitely.
All gangsta.
Yeah.
With the bitch, the train from Sri Lanka.
Yeah. We're just gonna hop right into the album. Oh, disclaimer before we get into it, we won't be doing all the songs because copyright reasons. We just want to keep it safe on our channel.
You want to watch us videos, right?
True.
Yes.
You want us to keep our channel, right?
True.
Right. And no strikes. And it's 19 songs. Like,
yeah, come on now. So you can listen to the album for that.
We already said it. We just said it. So I don't want to see any comments talking about how we didn't do every song.
Yes, because in the last video, we said that, and people were still like,
I know
I'm skipping around so much.
I'll find your IP address, pull up.
Because copyright. Okay. Talk to YouTube, not us, because they will flag our video. But anyway, yeah, let's get straight into the reaction. All right, first track is Ganja Burns.
I really.
it was really a beat.
That was good. That was a good beat. I like that.
Maybe like some hit cardio or something like that. it was cool.
That was nice.
It was weird. Good. Like as an intro though, I felt like it was like a track of the year, like in the middle of the album.
Yeah. True. Yeah. It doesn't feel like an intro track.
Cause I don't like
all.
Yeah. Exactly.
Not an intro track.
I expected more like horde boards for the intro track, you know. But I mean, I like that song though. So
I think that could be like a radio song. Usually, intros and albums aren't even like that song.
I mean, like statement songs.
Yeah, statement songs.
Like introducing how this is gonna sound for the rest of the.
Right.
Yeah, but I like it though.
But
cool.
It might sound like this. Who knows? And for three.
All right. So the next song we're gonna play is track number 3, which is Barbie Dreams, and this one has a star by it, and I've heard some stuff on Twitter about it. So let's get into it.
I've heard about this song.
Classic beat. Somebody go and make sure Karuchi okay though. I hope she thinks I'm trying to get a coochie to Quavo. They always want to beat it up, coon up the pussy. Man, maybe I should let them order coon up the pussy. Don't leave me crying and shit. Meek still be in my DMs, I be having to duck them. I used to pray for dogs like this. Face ass when I fuck them. Man, Uzi is my baby. Yo, that was fucked up, bro.
Damn, Nicki was. Why she gotta do him like that?
It's the perfect time. I think the little Drake bar was funny. It was witty.
Oh, yeah.
It was.
Yeah.
I'm sure he cool with it.
Yeah. Oh, no, yeah, he cool with it. Like I said, it's a setup. It's like an original Lil' Kim. Reminds me of, man. I'm not gonna bring it up because if I don't do the right name of the song, people in the comments will kill me. It's a 50 Cent song, though. Who's the fuck with Young Thug? I ain't addressing this shit. Who caught him in my dressing room? Still addressing this shit. I used to get this nigga to have a crush on Special Ed. Shout out Designer because he made it out of Special Ed. He said shout out to Designer because he made it out of Special Ed.
Oh.
Dang. I heard she name dropped a lot of people on his album. I know it could be on one.
I know, of course. I'm just playing, but I'm saying. But all jokes contain some true shit.
Yeah.
Shout out to my boy J. Cole. You know I'm all about them talent. I be supporting the stylist. I let them give me some brain. Using up my bitch moving. No, I ain't studying. No, I ain't moving. Damn, my bitch doing. Shout out to my juice. I ain't my bitch moving.
OK, Okay, so I love that last part because it definitely sounds a lot more.
She was speaking super fast, like super duper fast. Even though some of the subject matter I can't relate to.
Me being a man.
But I definitely do recognize wordplay, punchlines, and she just was doing her super duper flow right there. So I like that. I like the beat switch. And in the beginning, it was a funny song. I mean, saying a little witty name dropping all those guys. I thought it was funny. Yeah. Funny song. Like you said, it's blowing up on Twitter, so it's doing its job.
Yes.
So yeah, that was dope. That was cool.
The next song we're gonna go to track number 5 called Hard White.
Hard White.
That sounds like coke. Yo, I'm messing with this production.
Yeah, I like that.
This is a hard beat right
here. I like that. I ain't stopped rubbing my hands since the song started because it just made me want to just.
This is a hard beat.
Bro,
And she's killing. She's doing this justice.
I prefer this Nikki.
This Nikki is. She's going off.
Off, yeah.
Off. Wow, that was amazing.
That's probably my favorite song so far. I really like when she's just talking her shit, you know, especially because, you know, Cardi B's in the game, and I just like the fact that she's like reminding people, like, hey, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. I'm Nicki.
I'm Nicki Minaj, so I like that part.
I love that. I love Nicki, talks her shit, and it's amazing. I just transformed to like the highest level of bad bitch just listening.
Just right now?
Just right now. Yes. Wow. Right, so, next song we're gonna play is track 7, Thought I Knew You, featuring The Weeknd.
That's gonna be good. The chorus is really funny because I guess she's all the eyes just
It sounds like she's stuttering.
I don't know if she's trying to act like she's been drinking or something, maybe like I like the setup, but
I like
the
sound.
It's hilarious. It sounds good. It's cool. The beat was good for The Weeknd. I love how he came in there.
It was good for him.
Yeah, he's like really good. Like, sound like a ghost or something. I don't know.
Or like an afterthought or conscious, maybe.
Yeah, something like that. But he did cool, smooth.
And what I've seen is, like, on Hard White, like, the auto-tune, she's, like, working with the auto-tune, which she has before.
Yeah.
But it's, like...
Because she came on a Hard White, like, Tory Lanez or something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, she did. But it was a cool track.
She helped me.
All right, so the next track we're gonna play is track number 9. It's called Chung Sway, featuring Swae Lee.
Chung Sway.
Probably like my favorite song.
Chung, another Chung song. What's your fascination?
Chung Sway before Chung Lee. The little like back and forth she's doing.
Oh yeah, with the flow. Yeah, the flow is there. Yeah,
it's so good.
More importantly, Swae Lee is amazing on the song.
Who doesn't like love Swae Lee?
Yeah, shoot, like man,
he's making this song. Making this song for me personally.
Yeah,
like Swae Lee is a little under Ty Dolla $ign when it comes to features. So.
Yeah, I think everybody important puts him on their project.
Yes,
like for the most part, like but Swae's doing his thing on there.
Yeah,
I like
he's
how,
killing it.
I love when he goes to his singing little falsetto thing he does.
Yes.
It kind of reminds me like a "That's how you like the same." It's the same pitch or whatever. But yeah, I like it. I like this song a lot.
Okay, next song we're gonna play is Good Form.
Good Form. Yo, this is hard though. I was not expecting this, man. I'm talking about I picked this. But anyway,
yeah. We were choosing between Good Form and Nip Tuck. Brandon went Nip Tuck, he went Good Form, so.
Hey, I got Good Form. But yeah, I like the song. Yeah. I like the beat, really. That's what really got me. Yeah. She came correct as soon as the beat dropped.
She came correct.
For real.
She came like, right.
You know, you get a good beat.
She showed up okay.
Exactly, yeah. Because sometimes it's a good beat, and they people come in half-assed, but she came. Yeah. She couldn't play with you hoes.
Yeah. She came to slay.
Yeah, exactly. She came correct, bro. So this beat dropped. She was ready. She was started.
All right. So next song we're going to be playing is a Too Lit, Too Late interlude.
Interlude. So it's going to be nice and quick. And
a little too lit, a little too late.
It's just a little too lit, a little too lit.
What if she does that? What if that was like a... Like a
that would be amazing. I'd love that.
Yeah, I know you would.
We all love JoJo.
Feels like I'm on a tropical vacation. You
understand then, understand back then. Ain't you too much, too little, yeah,
too late.
Ooh,
all right.
I really wish that. I really wish that went longer, cause I like that, and I like all her singing behind her singing. I'm not like one to like Nicki singing that much, but like. Mm-hmm. I really wish that went another 2 minutes.
I didn't like the beat. It was really like, it reminded me of, it sounds kind of like what the Rainforest Cafe looks like.
True.
Like, I was like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, I like that I was in the jungle or something. Yeah. I don't know.
That was good. That was good.
Very much like a cover art. Like, she's like just singing to me after that.
Yeah, some Jungle Book vibes. Just,
okay, so next song we're going to do is Sir.
Excuse me, Sir.
Featuring.
Sir. The one and
the
only.
The one. The only.
Hendrix.
Future.
Future Hendrix.
Yes.
She said, I whip the foreigns to make them go faster. Like, I whip the foreigns like I whip to make them go faster. And that's why I love Nicki, man. No matter what the subject matter is, she has the wordplay of like any of the top rappers.
True.
So even if you don't rock with the music, or sometimes it's a little on the female side, you can't deny
her bars,
rap skills,
yeah,
bro. Because that's just a quick little example. Like that little punchline right there. Like,
she's a female Wayne. She said
that's
herself.
Yeah, exactly. Also, Wayne signed her.
Exactly.
I like that song. Only thing is, I don't know if Future was saying the same thing or different things, because it was so much.
I didn't really like Future.
I was about
bird.
To say, I don't feel like Future came hard enough. Like, Nicki killed
chair.
That, and then, Future just said sir again. Like, Nicki made it. She didn't say sir the whole time.
Like, there's a lot of sirs. I couldn't tell.
I couldn't tell if he was saying the same thing over and over again or not. And I'm a huge Future fan, so after years and years listening to him, I usually get to tell what he's saying.
Yeah, I can see what he's saying. Surf, he was trying to like.
True. I feel like he was slow. Just, I feel like he barely made the beat every time though. Like, sir, like he barely made the beat. Like,
I just feel like Nicki came really hard in the front
he
part.
He kind of came. It's kind of like on Grammy when he kind of just.
Yeah.
But sometimes he'll stand out, like on that song with Kendrick Lamar, like Miss Me with the, and he's like, Lottie, like he actually stood out.
Yeah, no, yeah, but it does run me just like Grammy, where like you expected him to come hard, and he was just like saying Grammy over and over again. Yeah. Okay, so the last song we're going to do is Inspiration's outro.
I'm expecting a whole bunch of hard ass bars.
Yes.
Throughout these whole
just episodes. To like, yeah.
Maybe
like,
some inspiring stuff.
Usually
cool.
When an outro is named outro, usually like a lot of hard bars. I don't know if you noticed that when somebody names their outro, or puts outro in their outro.
And it's inspiration, so I'm just expecting.
I actually enjoy outros of albums as much, if not more, than intros. So. Oh, is he on what? The beat go off?
Yeah. That's it.
That is the exact opposite of what I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, no, that was definitely not what I was expecting.
Very misleading title. Should we do
but it? But it went with the intro. That's the only thing I can say. It went exactly like with the intro.
It went with like, the outro was like you said, it was kind of like the intro. I think I got to read some articles about the album. I'm trying to figure out like, no, because the intro and outro sound the same. Everything in between sound like a separate rap project. I don't know, like where, like I guess it could, but the intro and the outro kind of does go with the cover art.
Yeah, no, I'm with you. Like the intro, outro, cover art.
But the intro and the outro don't really sound like a traditional intro and outro. Like we said when the intro came, How about like, that doesn't sound like an intro track.
And then the outro definitely don't sound like an outro.
It was like a minute long.
So short. Yeah. All right, guys. So to wrap up this video, any final thoughts?
I thought it was a good album. I liked it. You know, with Nicki, for me, since I'm not like a hardcore listener like that, I'm really lenient, I guess, on like judging her music. Mm-hmm. So I didn't really have any expectations for it, and everything sounded good. At least while we were here listening to it, I liked it. It was smooth.
With no expectations, it usually yields a good result, because when you don't expect anything, whatever you hear, it's usually good. So
the beats went hard. They were jamming. I liked it, man. Yeah. I liked it.
Production's cool.
I had high expectations for this album, and it lived up to my expectations.
Do you like this more than Cardi B's album?
I don't want to do that.
Yeah, it's not
I don't
want to
pin them against each other. They're both doing good.
We do that with the male rappers.
Like, not as much.
So which one you like better?
I mean,
like both of them.
I mean, we get slandered by whatever Cardi B's fans are called, but I didn't really like Cardi B's album that much.
Right, but it had hits.
No, it definitely had hits, and it was definitely, she did her thing on it because she did a lot better than people expected her to, but I like this album way more. But I'm just a Nicki kind of.
Right, like you said, there's like no reason to put them up against each other.
Yeah.
Everybody else is trying to do that.
They both doing her, they doing their thing, and they doing it well. All right, guys, if you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe.
Yes.
And check the description box, because all of our social medias will be linked down below.
We're getting a bunch of support from you guys. So we do appreciate that. We do see that. So thank you guys for y'all's views, man. We're going to keep it going.
Yep, and we'll see you guys in our next video.
Peace.